great guest on the phone right now, someone we talked to recently on the show. Kaylynn Iglesias joins us. Hey, Kaylynn.
Hi, good morning. Guys.
Morning.
Great news. I saw it on Facebook a couple of days ago. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. It has been quite the week.
Yes. You were searching for your birth family via social media. You told us about it recently on the show, and lo and behold, it happened for you recently.
It did. I have found my brother and my sister. They live in Florida. I reached out to them and found out that they have been searching for me their whole lives, too.
Wow.
And previously, when we talked to you, you had tried this before with no avail, and you decided to give it another shot. And I brought up the idea of how you did this on social media with taking a picture of yourself. You had that long style sandwich board with all your information, where you were born and who you were looking for. So how did that transpire in actually being able to find your siblings?
Well, what happened was people that saw that and then shared it ended up reaching out. And there's all people out there that have done this that know what they're doing as far as searching and the proper places to search. And I had a friend that I went to high school with had just found her husband's family and reached out to me and said, I want to help. So I gave her and another woman the information that I had, and they both pointed me to my sister Shelley because they found her post on another adoption site looking for me.
Really?
Yes.
And how long ago was that, that she was trying to find you?
Probably like 10 years ago.
Wow.
Yes. And I mean, I was registered on the same site, but they had different information because they were looking for my birth name.
Wow. So close, but so far away. I guess.
Yes. Huh?
And in Florida, where?
They are in Punta Gorda and Arcadia. Mm-hmm. So they're about 40 minutes apart from each other. And but still in contact, and still in contact with our birth mother's family. Unfortunately, she passed away in 1996.
Oh, okay. Sorry. What about a reunion with you siblings?
Yeah.
Oh my God, we're trying so hard now. If I could get on a plane right now, I would be there.
Yeah, good idea. It's a little chilly here.
It is, right? It is. We are going to make it happen. It's going to be easier for me to get there because not only do I have a brother and sister, but I now have 7 nieces and nephews.
Wow.
Between the two of them.
See how Christmas just changed for you?
Christmas just got huge. And everything just works out perfectly. We've already, we've lost 29 years, so we won't let another day go by.
And maybe getting a little bit more personal into this, when you were able to finally converse with your siblings, can you tell us a little bit about the emotion and what it was like in the conversation?
I don't think any of us have stopped crying. I was literally sitting at work when my sister messaged me back, and all her message said was, oh my God, I've been looking for you my whole life.
Hmm.
And I was done. It was.
And was that through social media as well?
Yes.
What's the age differential again with you guys?
My sister's about a year and a half older than me, and my brother's about 2.5.
Wow.
So we're all very close in age.
Great. Mm-hmm. And what do they do for a living?
My brother works for a company out in Florida as a paving company, and my sister works part-time but is more of a stay-at-home mom and her fiancé.
And were you all born in this area?
No, I was the only one born in Utica.
Really?
They're from the Lockport area.
Buffalo? Buffalo, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's where my birth mother's family still is.
Oh.
Wow. Very interesting story.
It has been beautiful, and we've picked up like brother and sister. We're already with the I love yous. We talk every day.
Yeah. Do you find that you have an amazing number of things in common?
Yes.
And do you look like each other?
My sister and I do in the eyes, but they actually look more like their father. So it's not like a striking, oh my gosh, we're twins, but the similarities in personality and likes and beliefs.
Like what? Like what are a few similarities?
Well, my sister and I have found out, are both very persistent, and my brother has warned me that she's the type where we both have said now we need to meet, and he's like, well, if I know Shelley, it's going to happen, because if she gets it in her head, it's going to happen. I'm the same way.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be in Florida within the next few months.
Awesome.
It'll happen. There's no stopping it now.
Wow, we can't wait to see the pictures of that.
Oh, I can't wait to hug them.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great story.
It's incredible. It's been incredible.
Well, I know you've lived some of this out in the public through our phone calls that we've shared and on Facebook. Are you giving out information for folks who want to follow along online somehow?
It's all on my Facebook. Everything that's posted, my sister had posted things and tagged me in them, as well as my brother. and I'm going to continue to do so. And I'm toying with the idea of writing a blog or mm-hmm. starting something, because I want other people to know that there is a happy ending out there.
Sure. And that was my next question. Maybe some advice for folks out there that are pursuing this same kind of thing.
Absolutely. And all the people that have helped me have told me that if I know someone else that needs the same help, that they would be more than willing to help them. So if people, you know, through my social media site and through Facebook, they're more than welcome to message me and ask me, because I will put them in contact with these people.
Great. Well, easily. best of luck moving forward, and thanks for sharing your story with us, Kaylynn.
Keep us updated.
Thank you guys so much.
Sure. No problem.